Welcome back! My name is ballerscuba. This is Video Games Over Time. We are still in 1982. Today, we're going to talk about Pitfall. The story of Pitfall takes us back to Activision. We have talked about Activision several times before. The third-party video game developer was responsible for Kaboom. We last talked about Activision in our video on Demon Attack. Pitfall was created by David Crane, one of the founders of Activision. David Crane is also responsible for Kaboom. David Crane had developed the technology to display a relatively realistic Running Man in 1979. In 1982, Crane was looking to create a game that could use this Running Man. He grabbed a blank sheet of paper, and within minutes, the idea for Pitfall was created. Crane then states he spent around 1,000 hours programming that concept. Pitfall is a platform game for the Atari 2600. In the game, the player plays as Pitfall Harry, an adventurer and treasure hunter, as he travels through the jungle. The game has a total of 32 treasures to find. Those treasures are spread across 256 connected screens, and the player has only 20 minutes to collect them all. To stop Pitfall Harry, the jungle has pits, quicksand, rolling logs, fire, rattlesnakes, scorpions, and crocodiles. Harry can avoid these obstacles by jumping, running, or swinging on vines. If the player touches any of the obstacles, other than the logs, the player will lose a life. If the player is able to collect all 32 treasures without falling into a pit or touching a log, the player can achieve a perfect score of 114,000. Activision advertised the game heavily. There were television commercials for the game in the lead up to its release. Activision also had a promotion that would give any player who could provide proof of a score of 20,000 a Pitfall Harry Explorer Club patch. Activision released Pitfall for the Atari 2600 on August 20th, 1982. That is the short backstory to Pitfall. With that now told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. And here we are in the game. This is Pitfall. As you can see, we don't get a title screen for Pitfall. We just kind of get thrown into the game. All we really get is copyright 1982 Activision, and that's going to be there the entire time that we play. But we do have quite a bit of information on the screen. You can see we start with 2,000 points. There's 20 minutes on the clock. We have two additional lives for Pitfall Harry. Pitfall Harry is hanging out with us right there. Now, this is a game that a lot of people really love, and therefore a lot of people have memorized a lot of this game. I am not one of those people. I have not played this game a ton. I have played a little bit, but I definitely do not have the game memorized by any stretch of the imagination. This is a game that I plan on playing basically two different ways. We're going to do what I'm going to call my normal run. This will be a run in which I try to play the game that I would normally play, just pick up and play. This is how I would progress in the game. And then I will, when that fails, I will follow a guide that's supposed to tell me exactly where to go in order to get all of the treasures and how to do that. And we'll see how far along I can get with that one. I'll put a link in the description to the guide that I'm using. My goal here is not to get a perfect score by any means. I do not think I can actually do that. My goal is honestly 20,000 points. I want to get that patch that I talked about before. Even though they don't, you know, give that out anymore, I want to be able to theoretically earn it. All right, so with that said, let's get into Pitfall. You can just start moving around and then the timer will go. So this is my normal run. This is how I would normally play the game. As you can see, we can go to the right. Lost some points already. We started with 2,000, and now I'm down to 1978. All right, let's... Oh, come on! I got the vine. Oh, right onto the log. Thank you for that. All right, you hit down to get off of this, by the way. And now we have the crocodiles. You can time it, right? Ooh. There we go. Being a little cautious there. Oh, you give me one right there. How nice of you. Yeah, so far we've only lost points. We haven't gained any points. I've lost almost 100 points. That's not working out well for me. There we go. Yeah, the logs won't kill you. Yeah. If you see a big empty screen like that, you know something's going to come. All right, there we go. 4,000 points for me. We're now up to 5,900. All right, we'll go there. Hop over here. Try to make it past the water. There we go. Yeah, jumped a little early. Yeah, if there's a vine, I am going to take it. And then we have the crocodiles again. Nope. Went into his mouth. Didn't get the jump just right. If you can land on the back of their heads, you'll be fine even with their mouths open like that. But it is much more difficult than it looks. And then I lost 100 points falling down there. I don't want to go down there. I do know that underground does move faster. Underground, if you go across one screen, it basically is the same as going across three screens above ground. So let's take this here. You have to hold down as you approach the hole in order to not fall. All right, let's see. Oh, come on. And I've failed at 5751. All right, we're going to do one more normal-ish run. This time I am going to go left because that is a thing that I can do. Yeah, it's kind of an instinct in me to go right in games like this, but in Pitfall, you don't have to do that. You can go left. Like I said, going underground is kind of the preferred way of going if you're trying to just travel, but doing that, you will not see a lot of the above ground screens. And the above ground screens are the only places where there are treasures. So you basically have to know what you're doing when you play this game if you're trying to get a high score or anything like that. All right, there we go. Doing all right so far. Yeah, you move at the same speed as the logs. You'll be forgiven if after watching as many Donkey Kong videos as I have done, if you think that these are barrels, because they have a very similar kind of look to them. Ah. There we go. Lost 100 points falling down there, but I didn't die. That's the important thing. Let's see what we can find. Eh, these things. All right, barely made that. Timing was just right. Oh, come on. Ugh, so close. You always spawn on the left side of the screen, so if you're trying to go left, then sometimes dying will work faster for you, but I wouldn't recommend doing it. At least it's not the way that I like to play the game. All right, let's go and keep going to the left, see if I can't find any more treasures. As you can see, there are a lot of empty screens here. Fine, we're down here, we're gonna go this way then. Made over the scorpion that time. You gotta time that just right. Alright, well, we have to go up here. No! There we go. Still didn't make the jump. I can't get the timing of it just right. Doing a little bit better, I think, but not great. All right, yeah, let's not do that. Yeah, you can jump into the ladder. I didn't know that. I tested it, but, you know, 100 points at this point is not going to be a huge deal for me. All right, what do we got, Harry? What do we got over here? No! Scorpion nicked my toe. Let's go over here. We'll head up. Keep going left. I have to deal with this. No, just a hair early. All right, so those are kind of my normal runs. As you can see, I don't get a lot of points. The first time I did better, I almost got like 6,000 points. If I hadn't gotten hit all the time, I would have gotten 6,000 points. This time, you know, it would have been like 3,700, like maybe 4,000 at the end of it. If I did it perfectly. This is a difficult game to try to get a lot of points in. You just kind of have to keep going and start memorizing things because they are in the same spot every time. So let's take a look at the guide. Hopefully I do remember to link that into the description of how I'm supposed to go through and follow this in order to get all of the treasures, hopefully in 20 minutes. The only way you can get all the treasures in 20 minutes is to go underground. So it's no surprise that's what they want me to do first here. All right, we're going to go down the ladder and go to the left. We're going to take this a couple screens over and come up here. We're going to keep going left. Nice little jingle every time we get on the rope. And then over here. No! There goes my perfect score! As if there was any question that I would just never be getting that. Alright, so we have to keep going until we get a treasure, basically, at this point. As long as I can time my jumps properly, we should be okay. We're not going to be okay. Let's see what I can do here. Just missed it. But I spawned on this side, so. There we go. There's one. I should have known. Alright, that did not work out well. Let's try this again. We're gonna go this way. Did worse doing that than I did normally. Alright. To here, and then we keep on going left. I was doing well, I just wasn't paying as much attention as I should. Like I said, you see an empty screen. You know there's going to be something that comes for you, whether it be a pit or water. It doesn't really matter. They both function the same way for you. It's death. If there's ladders in the middle, then it's fine. But if you're on a big empty screen, it is doom. It's just waiting for you. It's a long run! There are 200 and, I've heard 255 and 256. I went with 256 screens in the game, but I have heard 255 as well. All right, there we go, 4,000 points. Go, go, go. We made it. There went my perfect score again. I don't even know what I was trying to do there. And I'm going to land on a log. No. All right, I made it. Jeez, you can just hang out there and lose all your points, can't you? All right, we need to go this way. I guess I touched him. The game says so. It must be right. All right, so we can head up here. And then I want to go to the right. There we go. Go, go, go. Yeah, jumped just in time. All right, so that's my best score so far. It's not a good score by any means, but it is a score. Okay, so we want to go here. All right, we're safe here. Let's try to figure out where they want me to go next. We want to skip this one and take the underground option in the next screen. Okay. If I can make it over the scorpions, we have a chance. Nope. All right, we're going to try this one more time. One more time. I had a good feeling about it, but I can't get the timing of the scorpions just right because they keep moving on me. And one of the things... Let's try this again. Like, they do move, and one of the things that I believe about this game is that I don't really have that much time to pause and think about anything. I have to keep going if I'm going to get all of the treasures. That I don't really have time to stop and think about things. I need to just motor. So you just kind of have to memorize the pattern. And we're going to keep going until I get the money bags. And then we're going to keep going left after that. This one I always take cautiously. Nope. Too cautious. I need to hang out on the back of the head. Just run along the crocodile's head until I get to the back of it. And then we can call it good there. Technically, I didn't lose any points by dying, which I've always thought is a little weird. Sometimes it's better to die than to touch the log like I just did for 14 points. Or for 22 points like that. Alright, we should be good there. Alright, this one down. And then we have the scorpions to contend with. There we go. Like, I feel like it's a scary jump every time. That, like, you just gotta get that timing just right. Alright, so then from here we go to the right. Here we go, over the snake. Yes, even the snake's tongue will kill you. Do not touch the snake. Oh, I got scared. Jump at the edge just to be safe. I thought I missed that jump. But I will accept it. Okay. Keep going. We're going to avoid this one. And then head down here. Thought I missed that, but that's all right. Got that one. That one I was confident about. Oh, thought I had that one. Okay. You know, lots of stuff here. Let's go to the left, and we have a long way above ground to go. Nope, too bad. All right, so I do better following the guide than I do, you know, going by myself. But at the end of the day, this is a game about a lot of precision, memorization, timing, and it takes a lot of practice to get that. And although I do enjoy the game, I just don't have that practice in me to get those timings just right. But that is Pitfall now played, I should say. And with the game now played, let's talk about how it holds up today. Playing the game today, I do have to say that the game is fun. It is a game that I genuinely enjoy playing. It is a game that I want to get better at. I wish that I had the time to be able to practice the game, to be able to nail those jumps every time so that I didn't die on scorpions and didn't fall into lakes and I was able to jump across the crocodiles without hesitation. That's something that I would love to be able to do. I just don't have the time to dedicate to the practice needed to make that happen. It is a game whose graphics I think are astounding for the console that it's on at the time. The graphics, it's a full screen of stuff going on. Everything is pretty identifiable. The only thing that I have any issue with would be the logs that kind of look like barrels, but that's because of Donkey Kong. Everything else looks like what it's supposed to look like. The person looks like a person. Pitfall Harry looks like an actual human being running across the map. The vines look like vines. The scorpions look like scorpions. Crocodiles look like crocodiles. Fire looks like fire. Everything looks like how it's supposed to. And for that to happen on a game with so many screens is quite an achievement. And it's something that David Crane needs to be very proud of, being able to program the game to look the way that it does on the console that he put it on, with the space limitations and the hardware limitations that he had to work with. The sound also is pretty good. I would like more sound, but you know, it's the Atari 2600, so the hardware limitations are very present. But what little we had with the jingle going across the rope, the vine swinging across the pit or the pond or whatever we're swinging across, it is good. I like that little jingle. With all that said, I kind of want to look at it from a modern perspective, and that proves to be very difficult for a game like this. Pitfall, as we will talk about in a little bit, is a very influential game. And as a very influential game, a lot of what came after it expanded upon what Pitfall was doing. So for people that made games in a similar genre, and I would say that Pitfall is a little bit platform, but there's also a lot of adventure to it. So when it comes to the platform and adventure genres, a lot of future games looked at what Pitfall was doing, copied it, and then expanded upon it. And as a result, Pitfall, if you compare it to later games of the same genre, Pitfall looks very basic and kind of rudimentary, but that's because everyone else said, well, let's just do what Pitfall did and tweak it, see if we can't make it a little bit more to our liking. And so it's hard to kind of look back at a game like this. It's such an iconic game. It's such an influential game that it is definitely worth playing for that reason alone, simply because of its place in video game history. It is also a game that I enjoy playing, so I would recommend it for that. But at the same time, it doesn't age well in its genre. There are a lot of better, more expansive games out there in the genre because of the influence of Pitfall. So overall, would I recommend playing the game? I absolutely would. It is a game that I enjoy playing, and I know it's a game that's near and dear to a lot of people's hearts. This is arguably the best game that we have played for the Atari 2600. I know it's my favorite game that we've played for it so far. So a lot of people played it a ton. It would be their crown jewel of their collection, basically. Just plug in the Atari 2600 and it defaults to Pitfall. That's the way that they have it set up. That's the cartridge that's always in there. That's what they want to play. So it's something that is definitely iconic and needs to be looked at as such. In terms of replayability, I would say that the game has great replayability. With the gameplay, I think the gameplay is good. There's just, for me, looking from a modern perspective, I wish there was a little bit more of like a forgiveness on missing the jump just slightly. But that's just me, right? That way I can get further in the game if there was just a slightly more forgivable space on the jump. That's what I would like. But other than that, the gameplay is very good. The underground thing, trying to get all the treasures, all of that speaks to how fun this game is and how expansive it was able to get thanks to David Crane's programming. But yeah, looking at it from a modern perspective, it is definitely a game worth playing. It's definitely a game worth playing knowing where some of the treasures are, kind of skipping ahead of the practice that is required to be really good at the game, just to try to get a sense of what it would take to get all of this, how much practice you would have to do to try to figure out, okay, if I go down this screen and go across, then I take this ladder up and that'll take me where I need to go. All of that kind of stuff needs to be worked out over a long period of time. And the fact that so many people have dedicated that time to get good at the game kind of shows how good this game is. So for all those reasons, it is a game that I do recommend from a modern perspective. If you are to play it now, if you're thinking about whether you should play the game now to see what it's like, I would recommend doing it. It is fun. It is iconic, it is original, and it is highly influential, as we will talk about in the next part of this video. And that is my modern take on the game. When Pitfall was released, it proved to be very popular. The game would become the best-selling game of the latter part of 1982 and the early part of 1983. The game sold over 1 million units in its first 5 months. It would go on to sell over 4 million copies for the Atari 2600. The critics also enjoyed the game. The game was seen as a must-buy for the console, and was seen as the best adventure game that the Atari 2600 had to offer. As time has gone on, the game has remained popular. The game is often cited as not only one of the best games for the Atari 2600, but also one of the best video games of all time. The game would be influential, inspiring a new type of platform game that would be copied and cloned. Its mechanics would be copied and improved upon, helping to firmly establish the platform genre. The game would also help popularize the jungle setting in video games. The game would become so popular, it would branch out into other forms of media. The game would also see ports and sequels. We will keep an eye on all of these as we continue. Looking ahead, with another smash hit on their hands, Activision would continue to be one of the premier developers for the Atari 2600. We will be hearing much more from Activision again. As for David Crane, he would continue to work in the industry beyond Pitfall. We will also hear from David Crane again in the future. Perhaps surprisingly, we will also see the kid in the commercial for the game again as well. That will do it for the story of Pitfall for now. My name is Baller Scuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video, when we get our comeuppance.